You are watching the video Evaluating Internet Sources from the Evaluating Information series. This is Anna. She is studying at TU Berlin and is currently writing a seminar paper. She is in the Economics and Management Library and has already spent some time looking for suitable internet sources. She is finding it hard to evaluate which websites she can use, so she approaches the librarian Ms. Müller, who is familiar with the problem. Anybody can upload information onto the internet. This is why the internet is a huge pool of sources that are very different in terms of content and quality. But search engines do not find all information. They use a so-called crawler, a search robot that collects and saves URLs. Information that is stored in databases cannot always be found. Another problem is that information may become unavailable after a certain time if websites change. The order of hits in internet search engines is based on unknown algorithms, which makes it even harder to identify high-quality information. Anna asks Ms. Müller which criteria she should consider to assess internet sources. Ms. Müller tells Anna she should start by analyzing the competence and credibility of an author or website operator. Specifically, she should ask, is contact data provided? Does the author have an academic title? Does he work at a reputable academic institute? Does an academic institute run the website in question? Anna should also ask who the website is aimed at and whether the objective and purpose of the publication are recognizable. It is also important to find out how up-to-date the information is. The website's creation date, updates, and functioning links can provide pointers. Anna wants to find out more about how she can recognize the academic character of a source. Ms. Müller explains that the level of detail, a logical structure, comprehensible argumentation, correct spelling, and a factual, neutral, and objective style indicate the academic origin of an internet source. Moreover, academic sources contain no or only clearly designated advertising. Anna likes researching in Wikipedia and asks Ms. Müller if this is considered an academic source. Ms. Müller points out that any internet user can contribute to this online encyclopedia or edit content. The identity of the authors, their professional qualifications and motivation are unclear. This is why Wikipedia content should always be viewed critically and verified and not be quoted in academic papers. However, the online encyclopedia can be used to identify search terms and find background information. The cited bibliographical references may be useful for further research. Anna understands the criticism of Wikipedia and is glad she now knows how to evaluate internet sources. She thanks Ms. Müller. Ms. Müller and her colleagues are happy to help, either in person or by email at infokompetenz@wm.tu-berlin.de.